I think we're in a really unique position right now. 3 years ago, even when I joined the organization, we weren't talking about this the same way that we are today. Late night whispers are becoming mainstream conversations, and to be honest, it's the most thrilling thing we've seen in our generation.
It's so huge in the world, and you know, it's been the secret that everybody's been keeping for so long. And so, you know, I'm just hoping to help break that mold of its secrecy. You know, that's the only way that we are going to make a difference, is by breaking that mold.
If no one talks about it, nothing changes. If we don't do something now, then we're going to continue to have an epidemic.
It doesn't matter whether I'm getting into an Uber or sitting in front of the board. I hear these conversations and these stories constantly. We are finally in a place where these stories can come to light, where the survivors and victims can be respected, and where we can really make a dent in prevention.
It has been a movement that really impacts people and changes behaviors.
What we're seeing now is folks are starting to feel safe enough to come forward. And I think that's because of the prevention movements that have been going on in our country and in our communities for a very long time.
We are not here by accident. We are here because of the diligent, consistent, decade over decade dedication that our facilitators and others in our community have given to this topic. We are finally at a place where their voices are being listened to in the mainstream, and I am so proud to be a part of that. Our facilitators and partners have laid the groundwork for where we are today and where we're going tomorrow.
Child sexual abuse is so important to talk about, because without talking about it, we as a culture and society don't address the stigma associated with the trauma that happens in our community.
When others get that aha, that light bulb moment, that they now understand, one, the need to protect children if they don't already understand that, and two, they walk away with the tools to actually do that.
By the end of the training, I'm sending adults out the door empowered to protect kids and feeling like they can really do something.
Those little steps can make a huge impact. So I think the need and the want is there for something like this. I think, though, that there are still some barriers to break down when it comes to the words child sexual abuse.
The groundwork has been laid, the moment is here, but the work still continues. We need to make sure that advocacy organizations are supported for legislation, that the media still covers all of the gritty details that we talk about day in and day out. We need to make sure that more adults are trained than ever before. And I know that we have the partners around us to do it. It's just a matter of continuing the good work.
It's filled with passion and just this unending, relentless push to really bring people together and make change happen. And that is really cool to be a part of and to participate in and be part of that change that's happening around the world.
As wonderful as the Child Advocacy Center is, and as amazing as our staff are, our victim advocates, our therapists, our forensic interviewers, if we could have a child never have to cross our threshold, never have to visit the Child Advocacy Center, I just think that's huge.
As Darkness to Light looks forward to its 20th anniversary next year, we can't help but reflect on all of the ways that you have made it possible for us to accomplish as much as we have. Thank you so much for everything you do. Here's to the last 20 and on to the next.